So what we are doing here is we are seeking one application of Laplace transform, and this application involves the evaluation of some improper integrals with the help of Laplace transform. So let me tell you how can we do this. So suppose you are given find this integral, integration from 0 to infinity t into e to the power minus 3t sine t dt, right? So this is what we are given to find. So what we can do instead is, we know what is the definition for Laplace transform of any function. We know what is the Laplace transform of f of t. It is integration from 0 to infinity f of t e to the power minus st dt. So now you could compare this integral with the one given to you in the question. So here the limits of integration are same, that means they vary from 0 to infinity, and this e to the power minus, instead of this e to the power minus 3t, we have here is e to the power minus st. So from here you could make one conclusion that your s should be equal to 3. One thing, this is one thing that you should note. Another thing is that when you compare this, you have t and sin t, and this would be equivalent to f of t. So from here, you by comparison, we note that f of t is t into sine of t. So we can write this as the Laplace transform of this whole quantity, integration from 0 to infinity t e to the power minus 3t sin t dt. This quantity we can write to be the Laplace transform of this function t into sin t whenever it is evaluated by substituting s is equal to 3. So when you open up the definition for this one, Laplace transform of t sin t, it would become integration from 0 to infinity t sin t e to the power minus st dt. And when you compare this one with this one, so you only have this change. Instead of this s, we have 3 here. So this quantity now becomes Laplace transform of t sin t, and the limits varies from s varying from 3. So we have here is, we know what is the Laplace transform of t sin t. Firstly, we'll calculate the Laplace transform of sin t. What would be that? That would be 1 divided by s square plus 1. And when you multiply this by t, what you do? You multiply by minus 1, and then you take the derivative of this whole quantity. So we would have minus 1, and the derivative of this would be minus 1 divided by s square plus 1 raised to power 2, and then the derivative of s square, that would be 2s. So then this would become 2s divided by s square plus 1 square. So this is the quantity, and you have to evaluate this at the point s is equal to 3. So we'll evaluate it at the point s is equal to 3, at the point s is equal to 3. So here what you have to do, in place of s, put s is equal to 3 in the above expression. So we would have 2 into 3 divided by 3 square plus 1 whole square. So it would be 6 divided by 9 plus 1 whole square. So our final answer is 6 divided by 100, or it would be 3 by 50. So this is the final answer, and this is the value of this integral, indefinite integral, this one, right, which is given to you in the question. So we can have a look at one more example. It says that, so question number 2, it says that find or evaluate integral from 0 to infinity cos 60 minus cos 40 divided by t dt. So we have to evaluate this one. So for the solution for this particular question, what we'll first do, we'll compare it with here what we can do, we can write 0 to infinity cos 60 minus cos 40 divided by t, and we can multiply this by 1, there is no problem. And you could write 1 as e to the power 0s or e to the power minus 0s dt, there is also not any problem. because this is nothing but e to the power 0 which is equal to 1. So it doesn't make any difference out of this one. So next, because we know the Laplace transform of the function f of t, that is equal to integration from 0 to infinity f of t e to the power minus st dt. So on comparing this integral with the one given to you in the question, you have the value of s as 0 and you have the value of function as cos 6t minus cos 4t divided by t. So this is what you have in the question. So let us solve this. So what would we have? So it would be, firstly we'll calculate the Laplace transform of cos 6t minus cos 4t divided by t. So what would be this? Firstly we'll calculate the Laplace transform of this quantity. You know the Laplace transform of cos 6t is what? It is s divided by s square plus 6 square, that is 36, and then minus, as such the Laplace transform of cos 4t would be s divided by s square plus 4 square. 4 square is 16. So this is the Laplace transform of this upper quantity, and when you divide by s, what you do, you will perform the integration from s to infinity ds. So this is the quantity that we have here, right? So we have to integrate it first. So what would be its integration? So when you substitute s square plus 36 as some other quantity, say b, so 2s ds, that would be equal to d derivative of b, right? So we would have this as 1 by 2 log of s square plus 36 square root, not square root, but this quantity, and then here also minus half ln of s square plus 16, and the limits of integration varies from s to infinity. So here, before substituting the limits, so what we are doing here is, before substituting the limits, what we'll do, we'll just write this to be in this form, s square plus 36 square root divided by square root of s square plus 16, right? And then we'll substitute the limits after division by s square. So we would have log of 1 plus 36 divided by s square square root, and then we have 1 plus 16 divided by s square square root. And here we will substitute the limits, s varies from limits varies from s to infinity. So when you substitute infinity here, you would have log of 1, and when you substitute s here, what quantity you would have? You would have log of s square plus 36 divided by s square plus 16. So this is what you have. So here we will substitute the limits from s to infinity. So the first term would be 0. So we would have, after substituting these limits, we had this quantity, and thereafter what is the value of log of 1? Log of 1 is 0. So we have minus log of s square plus 36 divided by s square plus 16, right? So now what we have to do, we have to reciprocate it. So we have log of s square plus 16 divided by s square plus 36. So this is the result that we got after performing the Laplace transform of this quantity, cos of 60 minus cos of 4t divided by t. Now in the question, we have written this integral as the Laplace transform of this particular function. So now in order for this to be equal to this quantity, what we have to do, we have to put the value of s as equal to 0. So we will just put at the end the value of s as equal to 0. So we have the value of s as 0 here, the value of s as 0 here. So when you substitute the value of s here, you would have log of 0 square plus 16 divided by 0 square plus 36. So we have the value as log of 16 divided by 36. So this would be equivalent to, you could just divide this by 4, so you would have 4 here and 9 here, and moreover you could write this to be 2 upon 3 whole square. So this quantity becomes 2 times log of 2 by 3, right? So this is the final answer, and this is the value of the integral that we were asked to solve. We have shown that it is calculated using Laplace transforms. So I hope this concept is clear to you all. Well, that is it for this video. Thank you for watching.